want to run a missing persons on a former Landview Hospital employee, Jeff Barnes.
You are such a wet blanket. Get out of my life, Nora. You have no place in my life or my head. Goodbye. You are never going to cause me another problem, Nora Buchanan. Never.
I'll take over.
I'm back here again with you.
Let's make a baby together. Not by accident this time, but because we want to, because we love each other.
Lindsay, the timing is just way off.
But we could make it right. I went through something miraculous that you couldn't share with me. I want to make that up to you. It would be a way to put everything that's happened behind us and start over from here, move on. I would like to have a baby with you that we could love and raise together.
Having a baby to replace the baby that we lost. That's just not the way it's done.
Are you saying that your feelings for me have changed?
I'm saying that trying to have a baby right now is not a good idea.
I want to be with you. I want to make love to you.
Not such a good idea either.
What's standing in our way?
Go ahead and tell me. Tell me the whole story. Never mind, I know the whole story. They're keeping me as a prisoner.
Prisoner? Not my prisoner.
Then what would you call it? You haven't contacted anyone about me? You haven't told anyone where I am? Why are you keeping me from my family?
I have called your family. They've even been here to see you. Unfortunately, with all the pain medication we were forced to give you, you obviously don't remember.
You're lying. You are lying. Sam Rappaport knew I was here. He would be by my bedside day and night. So I know you're lying. And now I'd like to know why.
Okay. I really didn't want to have to do this, but I guess I'm going to have to tell you everything.
One Life to Live on ABC.
Bo?
Lindsay, you're a beautiful, loving woman, and I haven't forgotten how things were with us.
We belong together, I do believe that. And you deserve to have a child, and I want to be the one to make that happen.
Adding another child to the mix right now is just not a good idea.
Why?
Lindsay, you've lost a lot, and I'm sorry for that. But we can't act like nothing ever happened and go right back to the way we were.
I never stopped loving you, Bo.
I never stopped loving you either. Part part of me never will. I don't care what kind of a relationship that we end up having.
Is this because of your feelings that you have for Nora?
No. No. It has something to do with Nora, but it's not the way that you're thinking.
Sam Rappaport and the others aren't here because I asked them to stay away for now.
And you expect me to believe that they'd listen to you?
They listen to me because they care about you very deeply. You're extremely vulnerable to infection right now. Your immune system's taken a big hit, both from the injuries you sustained and the drugs you're taking. You're at a very high risk right now.
If I'm such a high risk, why aren't you gloved and gowned? Why aren't I in a sterile environment instead of somebody's bedroom?
This is a sterile environment. Which is exactly why I have to limit your exposure to the outside visitors.
Don't talk to me like I'm some kind of child.
Scarlett.
Don't call me Scarlett! My name is Nora Buchanan. Get that straight.
Okay. But even a bright, intelligent woman such as yourself, Nora Buchanan, can become a little disoriented and confused with the type of pain medication we've been giving you. Once the medication wears off, everything will be much clearer to you.
The drugs are not affecting my mind.
It's not your fault. It's not your fault. Their side effects have been very well documented.
I'm not experiencing any side effects, doctor. Because... I haven't been taking your drugs.
You said you never loved.
Maybe it'll work for you too.
Thank you.
Lindsay, I'm grieving for Nora. But it's not just that. You know, everything's up in the air right now.
This would be a way to settle things.
Having a baby is a major commitment. It's got to be made by people who know exactly where they are and where they're going. We don't know that, you know? Right now, we don't even know where things stand with Matthew.
Maybe he would like to have a little brother or sister.
I'm not sure that having another child is even the right thing for me.
It's because I lied to you, Bo.
This has nothing to do with you right now. This is about me. This is about where I am in my life. And right now, my priority, it has to be finding out where I stand with Matthew.
So maybe it's time that you go to Sam.
And what do I do? Just walk in and demand another paternity test? You know, Sam, he was in love with Nora. Okay, he's grieving right now. Do you have any idea how much that little boy means to him right now?
But that little boy might be yours.
Well, whether he's mine or he's Sam's, it's still, the fact remains, he lost his mother. So am I supposed to grab him out of his father's arms, too? I mean, that's the kind of thing that Asa would do. And the last thing I want right now is to be anything like my father.
It's just that the longer that you wait, the harder it's going to be for everyone, I think.
Now is just not the right time.
Don't you want to know, Bo?
I do. But this affects a lot of people. And I want to make sure that it's done the right way.
Lindsay, I need you. Oh, I thought I didn't realize you'd be here.
You haven't been taking the medication?
No.
Scarlett, you must be in agony. You're risking your recovery.
Physical pain affects the neurological and the endocrine system.